quiet. Come on. Relax, buddy. Wait, take a sipping cup or something, man. All right, so shalom, man. Once again, you're not under the sounds of the voice of KAHANTAZADAQ. Right, shalom. Once again, you're under the sounds of the voice of KAHANTAZADAQ. Tazadaq, little Taz, my head. Little Tazadaq, aka Zadaq. And I got my my boy Brandon over here. I don't want to use that name. I'll say Matthew over here. And I know you guys probably remember Matthew from some months back. And the good brother was really going through it. So the way that the story goes, and this is real life, none of this is made up, right? First of all, I'm going to shout out the Most High, man, for coming through for Matthew. All praises due to the Most High. All praises due to the Most High for coming through for Matthew. Matthew having the faith, man. So initially, what was that, Matthew? About 4 months ago when you initially reached out to me? And you was going through it somewhere around there?
Yeah, about almost 5 months.
Damn, it's been that long already?
Yeah, I'm flies.
Yeah. Come on, Zadaq, man. You can't act up like that, man. So, yeah. So, about 5 months. Yeah, 1, 2. All right. Okay. Yeah, 3. Yeah, 4. So, about 5 months. Zadaq, you interrupted me, buddy. You want to touch that, but you can't. Let me give you a phone. Yeah, so about 5 months ago, Brandon, you know, he reached out. He's going through a situation with, I guess, the soon-to-be ex-wife. You know, how was actually legally married in the system, right? Huh? And so, can you hear me, Brandon?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, so the way it has it, the long and the short is, you know, he caught her dirty. He addressed her on it. She decided to go into, I hate to say it, the typical female mode to blame him for something that she did. He caught her wrong. She takes his sons and just jumps ship in the middle of the night. She was that your car also, Brandon? Or the car was in your name? How did that go?
Yeah.
Yeah, so she, you know, she takes the car. She clears out the account. She got that fiat also, right? That was supposed to go to the, so she, you know, I mean, and this is why I always warn men about women. And this is why I wrote books like I wrote The Spokesman for Men. So Brandon got the book. This is the book you started with, right? Or was it Red Pill, Right Knowledge?
I got both of them.
Yeah, you got both. You got both of the books. And I told you to read the book. When you read the book, so Brandon got this book. Matter of fact, you might have been the first person to purchase the book, brother, on the real. I think you might have been the first, because that book was just released then. And I think he was like one of the first people to really purchase the book. So Brandon got the book tonight, Slim. I think you should get Red Pill Right Knowledge also, because when I was undergoing the custody issue is when I was writing that book, Red Pill Right Knowledge. I was writing, hey, don't turn off the internet. I was writing, I was writing what actually applies to, you know, to the situations that I was going through. So essentially, ironically enough, it happened in the same state. Now, if you look at the state of Virginia, Brandon, there's a female tyrant that's conquering a man. I don't know if you ever paid attention to that. There's a female tyrant standing on top of a man with a spear, and one of her boobs are hanging out. So ironically enough, when I was undergoing this, I had actually, because my son's mom she's from the Bronx, but she was in the military in Virginia Beach. I mean, Norfolk, right? She's in the Navy. So she was down there. So in order to do that, I had to literally go into the courts down there. Now, the way it has it, I wasn't there, but she kept trying to get me for support. Now, mind you, I'm already giving this woman way more money than she was entitled to. I was buying all of their clothing. I was buying all of their toys. It was never good enough. She wanted more. She wanted more, right? So the long and the short is, she literally went and got a custody order under the penalty of perjury because she lied under oath and said that I was properly served. And so the way that she got custody was really illegal because she sent the order to an old location that she and I used to live at together, right? So the way that I found out that she had custody is that her family's from Honduras. So in the summer, she took a trip to visit her father in Honduras. And so I had to try and register them for school at the time. They were still in public school. And so I wanted to register. The principal said, sir, we can't allow you to do this. I said, what do you mean? You can't allow me to do this. This is a right. I'm their father. She said, I'm sorry, we can't allow you to do this. That's all I could tell you. I said, well, hold on, what's going on here? I said, I'm their biological father. She said, sir, just go down to the courthouse. And that's all she told me. I get, you know what I mean? So the mom had told the school, don't allow, you know, me to register or anything. I'm like, huh? I figured it out after I went down to the courthouse. When I went down to the courthouse, I go and I talk to the lady. I said, I'm come here to put in a temporary custody order. Because the principal said you got to put in a temporary custody order to register. I'm like, all right, cool. I go down there. And then the clerk said, is there anyone that has custody right now? I said, no one has custody. We've never been to court for anything like that. And she said, okay, what's the names? She said, well, give me a minute. She go in the back, like 10 minutes, she come back. And she said, sir, I thought you said no one had custody. I said, no one has custody. I've never been to court for this. I've never been served to anything. She said, well, it says right here that the mom got custody in 2014. I said, huh? She said, yeah, the mom has custody in 2014. It says that you were served right here. Yeah. I said, no, I was never served. And that's what opened everything up. So when she did that, I said, oh, okay, she want to play ball? We're going to play ball. You want to play? Let's play. So, you know, I hit her with a show cause order, right? And meanwhile, this woman is sending sheriffs to my mom's because she can't locate me, right? Nobody really know where my domicile is. People think that I'm there, but I'm usually not there. I got a P.O. box over here. Got a domicile over there. Got Tazadaq Rolling Stone. You know what I mean? I got a lot of hats all over the place, man. Wherever I like my hat, that's not my home. I'm not like Papa. See, Papa was playing himself. He was a Rolling Stone. Wherever he laid his hat was his home. Wherever I laid my hat was just a temporary domicile, Brandon. So she couldn't get me sawed, right? So, but when I found out this, I said, oh, she really want to take this. Because the agreement, the verbal agreement that she and I had is that that's in the event of a divorce to never take this into the court, to never get our sons involved in that. She went totally against that. And this is why you always hear me writing things about women, because women are liars, man. And this is not, I'm not just saying some, I'm telling you most. The vast majority of women are like this. They come out of pocket. When they get in their emotions, you cannot take their word. So I'm telling every man under the sounds of my voice right now, if they tell you something, get it in writing. Get it in writing, man. Because they will betray you. And if you're not careful, it will destroy you. So the long and the short is, once I found that out, I hit her with a show cause order. To show cause, why? And there's a box that you could check on that if you want someone locked up. And so I checked that box because she's guilty of perjury. So now I'm hitting her with a show cause why she should not be locked up for lying under oath for perjury, and that custody be reversed and given to me, the father. Since she lied and she tried to attempt to prevent me from being in their lives, which makes her an unfit mother. You see what I'm saying? So now, the long and the short is, we go to court, the robe, here's her side, and here's my side. the custody is reversed. Same situation that you got. The sole custodian, and she has visitation rights. Now, from that, why am I saying that? Because Brandon pretty much has the same way. So another one for the fathers. And I told you, we're going to turn this thing around. So the more and more people... That's got to be Hashay time, Brandon. The internet just blanked out like that for no apparent reason, man. They don't want this message out there, man. But it's going, man. You can't. This is your house work, man. This is your. You can't stop this truth, man. He said, damn, he's putting this out, man. This guy, Victor, we can't let him tell this story. It's going to work more guys up. We can't do that. So the long and the short is pretty much Brandon has come to the same victory through the spirit of the Most High and his son, right? So now, Brandon, can you give him a brief synopsis? So what's been going on? The brother was being a good father. The brother tried to be a good husband. Turns out the woman's going on social media, sending out things to other men, and the brother caught her wrong. She comes out of pocket, takes his sons out of state, all the way across the country, one of them having a medical condition and thinking nothing of it. Thinking nothing of it. And then when she get over there, she puts in, what was she put in, Brandon, a protection order against you?
Uh-huh.
Brother was a threat. Is that not what she did?
Yeah.
So she put in a protection order against the brother, lying on him. So now the brother can't even talk to his sons. So I said, all right, brother. You know, this is read this book, man. First of all, read this book. Get yourself in the right place. Because you can tell the brother, you know, was, you know, really being bothered by that. You know, you can see that the hurt and everything that she was causing him. But when women get to that stage, they just don't care. They don't care. They just come out of pocket. So your brother start reading the book, you know. He start using some of the techniques in the book. Female over here start to get interested in him. Tell me about this little female that was interested. Another one started to get, so, you know, he get a little swag. Everything's cool, but at the same time, started reading red pill right knowledge and applying some of the tactics in there, because she was doing a lot of dirty stuff to this brother, man. I mean, this woman was really coming out of pocket. She didn't want him to talk to the sons. Don't call him over the phone, nothing. Then she literally had, because I was on the phone, brother, when she did it. She literally had the deputy sheriff, to go to this brother's home and try and seize all of his weapons because she said she's frightened for her life. How you frightened? You all the way on the other side of the country. But she's frightened for her life. So that's the long and the short of it. So now, Brandon, can you give the people a brief synopsis of what you actually went through and tell them the end result? Because the brother just came from court today and he texted me. He said, sole custody. So what are you talking about, man? I thought he was saying she got sole custody, man. I said, man, you ain't speaking clear, man. Speak clear. And then the brother said, no, I said, oh, man, oh, praise it due to the Most High, brother. That's beautiful. I think I was more happy for the brother than he was for himself. I say, yeah, man, that's beautiful, man. Beautiful. And I say that again, man, that's beautiful, man. And then this is why the scriptures say all wickedness is but little to the wickedness of a woman. All of you men that don't take heed to that, you're going to be the next victim. So go ahead, good brother.
Yeah. Already using the tactics in the book. And it's like every time I did something out of the book, it's like she was reading the book herself and she was doing the same thing back as if she was a step ahead or something. So I had my aunts and stuff because she went to school for paralegal. I had her helping me get my legalese correct when I was doing my paperwork and everything like that, because I was taking everything out of the Red Pill Right Knowledge book.
Right.
I didn't think I had to get straight was my legalese. And then after that, I also had a pastor who was a lawyer help me out with the trial stuff and everything. So that way I could end up getting everything straight. So that way when I went to court, everything was good, because she was sending affidavits into the court that were perjurized with false statements and everything. If it weren't for that book, I would have pretty much got railroaded. She tried to put me on child support and all of that. I was sending in all of those documents and stuff. And I was
now, Brendan, to my understanding, this woman, did she not state in court that she don't want you to be able to see the children at all?
That was her downfall. The judge was mad about that.
Now, what was the guardian lighten shooting for?
For her to have physical custody and for me to have visitation.
Now, but the judge didn't favor that ruling, now did he? Because this shows you how the system could really be screwed up, because she took his son. One of the sons had a medical condition, and she's taking him across country, you know, not concerned about his medical condition. And that right there was partially, you know, not if not all, showing that she's an unfit mother, man. Because what mother that really care about her sons would do something like that? But it's done often, and they often get away with it, man. I kept telling the brother, no matter what, man, you got to stand strong, man. Stand strong, man, and keep fighting. So, Brendan, when you went in today, now, was it on line, or was it physically, were you physically in court?
I was physically in court. She was online.
Okay. All right. And so this type of hearing, it was a custody hearing, and was it also the hearing to get rid of that, what was that order, a protection order that she had against you?
Well, that's what also went against her also, because it seemed like she tried to underhand everything. If it weren't for you telling me to go ahead and file for the custody, I would have still fighting for my son. Because after I filed for the custody, she went and put the protective order in. She tried to make it seem like they had jurisdiction.
Right.
The paperwork, they found out pretty much Virginia had the jurisdiction.
It stopped hitting this button. Right.
After that, the judge was looking at everything, and the guardian Lytle questioned her about whether my son was seeing a doctor, and she was like, nah. And so the guardian Lytle was like, with him working nights, it would be good for the mother to have physical custody for their daily.
Yeah, you see that? You see that? I know he's going to try and play some semantics like that. And so this is why I told you, make sure one of your family members will vouch and say that I could watch him then.
I had my mama and my grandma there. And
right. Well, what'd your mom say?
They were saying they was willing to watch him. My mom.
All right. All right. There you go. Stop pressing these buttons, man. You're screwing me up. Yeah. So, now, how did it kind of go today, Brendan? Did she have a briefcase? Did the ex-wife have an attorney today?
Uh-uh.
All right. Did she have one before?
Uh-uh.
All right. So she was putting all that foolishness together herself, probably with the assistance of a family.
It was, because you could tell from the way the documents were prepared. She was trying to say the kids were born out of wedlock.
Yeah, but I mean, that right there was crazy, man. But like I told you, I hate to say this, Brenda, I think he was kind of dealing with a basket case. Because if they was born out of wedlock, she laid down with you. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And we don't see it like that. According to the scriptures, the extra set. The act of sex constitutes marriage, man. You know what I mean? Then you go and draw up the contract. But, you know, she was just coming up with nonsense, man. Just anything to try and, you know, make you look like just this really bad, unfit man that's a threat.
Yeah.
All praises, man. All praises due, man. All praises. So now, Brendan, when the judge rendered his decision, how was it going? What did she say in court? That at any time did you think, man, I'm going to win this? When did you feel like, yeah, I'm going to win this?
The day you told me, if our father is with us, who can be against us?
Right.
And so I was thinking about that all day. I was listening to scripture about it. When I got up this morning, and on the way to the most high, man.
And so when the God of your light him said, I think it should be with the mom. Now, I'm going to tell you something. That had to be the most high with you, Brandon, because about 90% of what the God of your light him says, that generally determines who gets custody. Did you know that? So yeah, they have a heavy weight on the decision that the role makes. So yeah, man, all praises due. Now, so when the guardian said that, what did the robe say? What did the judge say?
He was upset because in her testimony, when she testified, she was saying she didn't want me to have no relationship with my sons or be.
And the judge, what was it? Was it Robert, Edomite or Jay?
Edomite. All right.
Now, how did he respond when she said that?
He was mad because he didn't feel that was right.
See that? Now, at least he could see that. Now, even the Robert had to say, "Nah, man, this is out of pocket. These women are coming out of pocket. And they ain't getting away with murder." Even the Robert, he had to film that. Because he probably had to envision himself in that place. You see what I'm saying? This could be me right here. But I can't see my sons at all because this woman is making a decision? Wow. And what's up with Friday, Timothy Starks? What are you talking about, brother? But yeah, Brandon, man. All praises due, man, that you stood up. It's not enough men that's willing to do that. It's willing to stand up. Go in and face these systems, man. And this is why so many, boys and girls continue to get taken away from their fathers. And a lot of these children are growing up with personality disorders because they don't have no father figure in their life. This is why this alternative lifestyle community has become so rampant in our communities because there's no male figure there. There's no male figure. So even many of the young boys, they're growing up with female tendencies. They exhibit a lot of feminine energy in their relationships. They argue with the women. And most of these women, they're just damaged goods, man, because they lack that father figure. So when they get with a real man, they don't know how to deal with a real man. And this is why they have this insatiable desire for effeminate men like Michael Jackson, Quench, the barge, the people like that. They're not accustomed to dealing with real men. So they don't know how to treat a man. And so when they interact with a real man, the man's only going to be around them for a short time until he say, you know what, I can't deal with you anymore. And then they try, well, what's going on? You promised me forever. Yeah, I promised you forever, but you didn't tell me you was going to be an asshole. You didn't tell me that you was a borderline. See, I promised forever with a sane woman. Not with a borderline, not someone with a personality disorder. You didn't tell me that you was damaged goods. And so this is the problem that men have to start developing into. You must look beyond the facade that the woman paints at the inception of the relationship. Because when you first meet her, she will fold your clothes. She will try and make love to you as good as possible. See, that's just to win you over. See, it's an act. She comes out in her best costume, some sexy clothing. Once you get stupid enough and you push up a ring and said, I do, what she's saying in her mind is, nigga, you through too. You doing, you through. You're done now. If you notice, now it sounds trivial, but she starts acting differently after that. She'll start treating you differently. She used to run and get you a beer. You come home, you had a hard day's work. If a man, you know, I don't work outside of the system. If a man had a hard day's work, she kind of rub his feet. She's trying to win you over. But then, once you get naive enough to push up a ring, come on and say, yeah, yo, sweetheart, let me get a beer. She look at you. She said, what's wrong with your hands? Negro, you can't get it yourself? He said, damn, baby. Before we got married, you used to get me a beer. She said, I don't see nothing wrong with your feet. You walk over there and get it yourself. Everything changes. And some of you could be a witness to this because you know it's true. That's right, brother. It's that Jezebel spirit. It's that Jezebel spirit. And that's in too many of these women out here, man. It's in too many women. And so more brothers really have to stand up and, you know, face these feminist courts and just go in and show them the law. Like I told Brandon, so as long as you keep good notes, man, and you have faith in the Most High, and you do this stuff, you're going to come out victorious, man. But, you know, you got to stand on it, man. You just really got to believe, man. And it's just not enough guys willing to do it. A lot of guys run. You know what they do, Brandon? They run from state to state, trying to run away from child support. See, and that's the problem. You don't run away from your feds. You're supposed to run towards what you fear. That's what a man does. You run towards what you fear. Even if you're afraid, you got to face it anyways. Right?
Yeah.
You have to be totally undaunted. Whatever it is that you fear, you better learn to conquer that thing. And you conquer it by running towards it, by facing it, not running away from it. So now, Brandon, in your order, can you tell us what that order says? Would you happen to have the order with you?
If not,
can you paraphrase what the order says?
The court grants the father sole and legal custody.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. All praises due to the Most High. All praises is due to the Most High. You hear that praise? Yeah, tell them one more time, Brandon, what the order says.
The court grants the father
beautiful
custody.
Hey, I hope you're listening, Brother Armstead. I told you could. I was talking to a brother today, man, about the same kind of thing. They're trying to get him. But I told him, I said, man, I don't give a damn what state you're in, man. If you show him the law, you could win. If you show him the law. And so, and this is why I tell people that these kind of classes and things are so important. Now, you got to be honest, Brandon. If you didn't attend any of these things, you wouldn't have had a clue how to submit any of this stuff. Because I remember telling you how to submit a lot of this stuff, man. You got to go down and do this. Go down and do that. So you got to know this stuff. You see that? Daryl Suber, I knew you would be on this call. Because you got to, but you're not around enough, Daryl Suber. You got to really learn this stuff. You can't have staff with it. You really have to learn it. You have to stop all of the BS, and you really got to, you know, bow down and learn this stuff. You got to submit yourself to the Most High, and you got to give yourself the time to learn it. You cannot do this half-ass. You got to learn it. And you know, Brandon, I was hard on you, man. I was coming on you hard, because that's what I do, man, to try and make sure you get that W. So, man, listen, man, this woman is not, and she might, you know, she might used to love you, but this woman is your greatest enemy. Did I tell you, Brandon? I said, listen, man, you need to go and file a custody order. You need to file for custody of them, man. Because this woman is going to be doing dirty things to you. By the time I told him that, the next day, you got a protection order against her. Sheriff's knocking on his door. You got any weapons here? That's how they do it, man. That's how they do it. So anyone under the sounds of our voice, man, that think that this stuff don't work, man, if you persevere, if you have faith, it will work. And I don't think you understand that this is a huge victory for men, Brandon, because the state that you did it in, That state, Virginia, man, I told you, man, when you look at that flag, that's why I put the flag in the thumbnail. You see that woman standing on top of that man like a tyrant with one of her boobs out. She conquered that man. So that's essentially the motto of that state. Why do you think they call it Virginia? Virginia is a woman. Virginia is a woman. Yeah.
You just got to keep working at it, because even if you don't understand it, just go back and keep rereading. Because eventually, it's, like above my head right now, a light bulb goes off.
Come on. The problem is, Brandon, sometimes their light bulb goes off, but it blows. Their light bulb blows. And they'll be in a triple stage of darkness. They don't have no light. Mm-hmm. That's what it is, man. So the brother, there's another brother out there in Richmond, man. I was coaching today, man. I hope he's tuning into this call. And I hope he's taking, you know, heed that you can win, man. This is a blessing. This is a blessing in a big way, because it happened in a commonwealth. It happened in a state where men typically get railroaded. And I tell you, Brandon, if you didn't submit that stuff the way that you did, you wouldn't have stood a chance, man. You wouldn't stand a chance, because that state is called Virginia for a reason. Virginia is a female. All praise due to the Most High, man. Yeah, I got so the next step, Brandon, you got to fly out there and get your sons, right?
Yeah, I'm trying to find out a plane ticket now from Charlotte. It's cheaper that way, because either way you try to get over there, you got to fly to Charlotte and then fly back from Charlotte on a small jet. And that's just the extra $200 to $300 just for that one little small 45-minute ride on the jet.
Yeah. But it's worth it in the end, bud.
I really think about
it. Sons are worth it, man. And they will be eternally grateful when they get older. To know that my father went to court and fought for me. Trust me. Trust me on that one.
I know. I kept all the paperwork so when they get older, they can read it for themselves.
Right. All of the men on this call, and then you men that's undergoing this, I told you, man, get my book, A Spokesman for Men. Get Red Pill White Knowledge. And get You Can Win Child Support. It's a downloadable from the website, www.truedisciplesofchrist.org. It's Shalom, Carefoot. That book shipped today. It's going through customs, so it may take a little longer than usual. Yeah, we need more people to come forth with these testimonies. There's a lot of people that get, they get wins, and then they just go on their merry way. You know, and I think that's doing a disservice to this assembly and this movement, because they come over here, they get information, and then when they're okay, you don't hear from them again until they have another problem. Mm-hmm. You need more testimonies like this, more people, because it gives people faith, because a lot of these people are utterly broken. They're utterly broken. Praises, brother. All praises to you for getting custody in a state like Virginia of your two sons, man. That's the work of the Most High, man. All praises due to the Most High, man. That's a blessing. I'm telling you, man, all you men under the sound of my voice, man, I'm going to say this, man. Do not trust a woman. She has to earn your trust. You better try that spirit. And you try it over and over and over again. I done dealt with a lot of women in my life, man. And women that say one thing, and they do just the opposite. There's a reason that the Most High have so many warnings in the scriptures about women. The scriptures say all wickedness is but little to the wickedness of a woman. All wickedness. The wickedest thing that you could think of is but little to the wickedness of a woman. And this woman completely exhibited that when she decided that she was going to break away from this brother. How are you this brother caught her sending, you know, really disgusting photos to some guy. Then when he questioned her on it, she decides she's going to take his sons and flee. Take his car, work out, wipe out the bank account. So I pray that every brother on this call will learn and take heed to this so that you do not repeat what this brother, this good brother had to go through. Go ahead, Tim.
I just want to say thank you for real. Like, for real, thank you from the bottom of my heart. As I said in the chats, I've been doing this all day. I had to drop my kid off, and I had to drive him 45 minutes today because she decided to move.
Wow.
And it was the first time that I actually had to deal with it. I've been just dealing with it because it's convenient for work, and I've been going with the convenient excuse. And I was praying literally today all day, saying I need wisdom, I need guidance. And my first reaction, I was talking to my dad and I was saying, you know, there's this guy online, you. And I was like, he's got these books, your books. I need to buy them so I can deal with this. And what shows up but this? If this isn't the work of the Most High, I don't know what is. Like, for real, thank you.
Please just do, brother.
And pretty soon I'll have that 100. I got half right now, but we're going for 100 because 100, that's what he needs. That is, she is literally ignoring a doctor's advice for, he needs chiropractic care because he can't walk straight because he's too lazy over there. Yada, yada. I mean, I could go on forever, but I'm not going to. But effectively, my son is suffering because she's too damn lazy to bring him to the chiropractor when I would pay for it. Like, no problem.
I know what you're saying, Ken. Tim, I know exactly what you're saying, man.
Anyways,
a lot of things that I've seen, man, I just couldn't put my mind around it. This woman not willing to do this. How can I be a man and know how to do this and a woman can't do this? I just, and it incenses me. I would tell you, it results in me hating her, man. I can't even. Because if you want to be my enemy, all you have to do is mistreat one of my seeds. That will turn me against you, man. That turns me against you, man. That really bothers me.
You know, and to be honest with you, for anybody that's not in this situation but potentially would think that it would be a good idea, this man has some really good thoughts, like don't date a hoe. Don't make a hoe your baby's mama. If she's got more than one baby daddy, there's a reason that she's there. Don't mess with, you don't go to a barber shop unless you're going to get your dang haircut. Like, for real. I mean, when I go in, I get the shave, I get the haircut, you know, I come out looking fly as hell. That's because I went in there with an intent.
Right.
Don't do that to yourself. For real. Look at all of these men saying thank you for getting out of the situation. Heed our wisdom. It's not wisdom because we got it because we were smart. We got it because right. We did something dumb and we're coming out of it.
Yeah, I went through it. I went through it.
I've been watching some of your older videos after I plugged in on the other, and I've just seen the growth and the maturity, and you know, like the hand of the Most High is truly on this man. You know, I don't always agree with you, but I don't have to.
Right.
You know, I don't always like what you say, but I don't have to.
Right.
The beauty of it is you're teaching right knowledge. So it's from the Most High. So I can ignore the things that I don't like and study them and find out why I don't like them.
Right.
You know, anyways. Thank you.
Nick, careful. I got to step away for a minute.
Have a great afternoon. I'm going to jump off so everybody else can talk. Otherwise, right. I'm going to keep on going because this is like on my brain. Have a great one. Right. And congratulations, sir.
Thank you.
Thanks, Tim. And I just came on to just say thank you to Matt, because you know, I don't have a son or daughter, but I'm this does worry me that this something's gonna happen to most men. So it's like when someone who has got the testosterone and like has a pair and wants to come forth and be like, all right, I did this and it worked, that kind of restores some faith in me, because you know the commerce side is one thing. You know, the criminal law is one thing, but the family thing is like, you know, that's foreign to me. I don't know anything about it. So, you know, I'm glad that you were able to zero in and win in a Commonwealth state, because Canada is a Commonwealth state, and that's where I'm at. I have a DC jurisdiction. So up here, it's, you know, I only see female magistrates up here. I rarely do I ever see a male judge, if ever. And even then, they kind of live that alternative lifestyle if they are a male judge up here. So it is kind of like one-sided, so that it's a good thing that worked out. And I know there's a lot more people who've had success with these methods, and they really should come forth, because we need more testimonies like this, so people double down on the truth. Because the more people who find remedy and it's better that the sewer gets the cholesterol moved through it, because it's most of these kind of cases that kind of disturb me. And you know, I've seen a lot of stuff lately that it's just like, you know, the world's going somewhere that's I don't think people are prepared for. And you know, if you're gonna let, you know, people who, like, I don't know, I got pinched by a BPD broad just recently and thrown in a box, because all on what she said on hearsay, right? So you know, they have a lot of power, women, and especially with the system. So if when you double down on paperwork and say, okay, well, look at my paperwork, what does the paperwork say? I know that those administrative offices don't like having the process served on them, and I know that from whenever I do these kinds of administrative remedies, I know for a fact that the judicial system, it has to do what the paperwork says, because you're showing them the law. You're saying, okay, well, it's the law, man. What is the law? It comes back to this, to the word. It comes back to like everything we learn here. It's all based on a spiritual foundation. And if you're not living right, and you're getting yourself into these situations that, that we find ourselves in as men and women, it's like, you know, it comes down to like, well, what made us not be on the path to begin with? Well, you know, you didn't come into this world with someone like KAHANTAZADAQ's authorized representative to disseminate these things to you. You know, we were brainwashed from a young age by Sesame Street, the education system, medical system. So I don't know, man. Like, I appreciate you, Matthew.
Hey, careful. You got that? I sent you an email with that tracking number. You got it?
No, I didn't even look at that. No,
yeah, it seems like my emails be bouncing back from you, man.
No. I just put that on there because I don't want people sending me emails. Let me get rid of that. Hold on here. I'll fix that.
Yeah. they bounce back, man.
I'm sorry, but that's funny, because I've heard about that email all day long, because I watched that video from this morning and you were mentioning it then. That's funny. I'm sorry. I'll leave.
I'm going to put that tracking in the room, Carefoot. Matter of fact, I'm going to, hey, you can write this down.
I got it. I pulled the email up right now. I'm typing all it right out. Where do I check this though? What website? Is this USPS?
It's USPS. But the problem is, once it gets customs, you can't check it. You can only check it stateside. Once it gets in Canada, there's no way to track it. That's the thing about customs forms. I had to fill out this custom form because it went to Canada. There it is right there, Kerfoot.
Beauty. Yeah, I'm on USPS right now. It's accepted. I see it right now. It's on its way. They're in possession of the item. Get updates. Yeah, here we go. I'll click this. Yeah, I want all the information. Boom, boom, boom. Here, okay. They can text me. Okay, here we go. I understand. Get updates. Email. Yeah. And I give them my first last name. Okay. Email.
So Brendan, what do you have to say to other brothers out there that may be undergoing this, Brendan? What's your word for that?
Get the book, read it, and understand it. Because the thing is, you're going to end up doing most of the work by yourself. There's going to be people to help you. But the thing is, unless you read what you're understanding in the book and understand what you're reading, pretty much people are going to be pushing their own ideology of what they feel or think you want. Because I was trying to get physical and legal custody at the beginning. But everybody else who kept trying to push for joint custody, well, I would end up with visitation. But with the book, it shows you how you can get sole and legal custody and get physical custody also. It also shows that pretty much if they try to deny you joint custody, there's cases and there's Supreme Court laws that show that pretty much.
Put your church rules on.
Matt. Give me some more time, man.
Yeah, I'm gonna take you to church. Put your church clothes on.
I took a hit, man.
I'm gonna take you to church. Put your church clothes on.
I took a hit, man.
But like, that's all right. Don't matter if you took a hit, man. I'm gonna take you to church. Put your church clothes on.
Like you, man. I took a hit.
Let's go church, man. What?
Yeah, wild up there in New York.
Yo, Vasco, man, I'm waiting on you, man. You put something out there, man. I'm just shouting you out, saying, yo, Vasco, what you doing, man? Get on the move, man. See, that's what happens when you procrastinate, Vasco. If you say it, you got to make it happen, man. Otherwise, it's never gonna happen. You're gonna keep putting it off.
I understand that every day, I promise you, I really am.
Your
boy, man. Alpo? Yeah, wild in New
York. Who you talking about, Alpo?
Yeah, Alpo, man. Your man is Alpo. I don't want to be like him, man. I'm not going like him, man.
Yeah. I hear you, man. Just keep stay loyal, man. Stay loyal to the hood, man. Stay loyal to the streets, man. Keep your mouth closed, man. If you get caught in everything, don't start Sammy the Bull. If you get on the stand and start singing like Sammy the Bull, man, you create enemies. In New York, they let you rock for a minute. Then when you think everything's cool, bam, bam, hold that. Rock-a-bye, baby. That's kind of what happened, man.
That's Minneapolis, too.
Nah, man. That's anywhere, man. Nobody like people that, you know, if you out there in that game, Roscoe, you get caught, you got to eat that. If you start talking and get a little less time, man, there's some people that really, you know, they know the code of the streets, man. If you get caught, don't say nothing. But this little new jack swing that they got going on, Everybody talking, man. Everybody singing like Keith Sweat, man. Because they don't want to do that, you know what I mean?
They ain't trying to go there. They begging the system
like Keith Sweat beg abroad. And you know Keith, he's a master beggar. He's a poor representation of a strong man. He be begging, man. The only man I know beg more than him was James Bent Brown, because he made a whole song that says, please, 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 please. That's what the song's about, man. Please. All he's saying is please, man. He begging. Damn, James, that was one of your worst songs.
Man. Could it be?
Yeah, could man. But that, yo, Roscoe, I was just telling you to get back on deck, man. Go ahead, you got me? Go ahead and do that.
I got 700, man. I'm going to try to see.
Yo, this is not the form right here, Roscoe, man. This is not the, yo, you sound like you, come on, man. You sound like you pushing something to me, man. Come on, Roscoe, you got 700 for what? You got to let them know what it's for, man. They trying. Come on, man. They gonna associate that with pharmaceuticals or something, Roscoe. You got to come clean.
Okay, but if you give me 2 weeks, though, I will have it, though.
You got to come clean, Roscoe. It sounds like you're making some sort of transaction, man. If you're going to talk, man, talk to me on the private side, man. You already know, man, they trying to look for a reason, man. I'm going to take you to church, man. Put your church clothes on, man.
He just screwed me right there, though. I can't even say that. I guess he just... I ain't listening to the pastor. I ain't been listening to the pastor.
Like, now, I'm talking about I'm going to take you to Roscoe Church, man. I'm going to take you to Roscoe Church.
I ain't been listening to the pastor. Listen, I was at a funeral, right? Man, why can I not take the pastor serious? He was asking me...
And so, hold on. Future technology, if this stuff doesn't work in any court, why are you here? Why are you here? This guy in the room saying this stuff don't, there's always one of these people that come around, man.
That stuff excelled. With Excel.
If it doesn't work in any court, why are you here?
How do you know who Tazadaq is, and yet we don't know who the hell you are, future technology? Right.
How does he even know what we're talking about?
A different status.
I still haven't seen his face, so... You know, if you're not even willing to show your face, I mean, come on now.
It is good.
Prove your claim, dude.
Hey, future technology, I want you to get on the call. Click that stream link.
Yeah, come on in.
Just work for Matt.
You want anyone to work for him, man? You want to work for him. He's trying to see. So he got to find a way to say it don't work.
You got a StarCraft 2 emoji. I know that game, man. You got a Protoss icon.
Yeah, this guy is one of them. This guy is one of those losers, probably, that sit up in a room and has nothing better to do with his life.
It's not up in a room. It's in his parents' basement, man. That's that mentality right there. Is there a spirit called the parents' basement? Like, I'm for real asking, because I've seen like a massive trend between video games and all that. Like,
Come on. Where's that guy at, man? Let me find this guy, man. Block him. David, are you still a moderator, man? Block that dude. Where did he go at? Yeah, David, block that guy, future technology. I'm looking for him. Where is he?
You gotta operate that estate, man. You gotta operate that estate.
Last thing we need is some debtor to come over here to try and rain on Matthew's victory, man. Just hate, man.
Everybody wanna be somebody.
Always work for me. I've never seen it fail for me.
David, where are you at? Present thyself. Block that. Why don't I see him in a regular chat room? I'm trying to block him on YouTube. David, block future technology. Make prayers and moderator, man.
He's one of my haters because he's got a StarCraft 2 emoji. I used to play that game in Korea, man.
And I get all them books too, you said.
Roscoe, you've been talking that for a minute now, man. Uh-huh. That's that feel-good talk. It makes you feel good. When you say you're going to get it. you've been talking that for a minute now, Roscoe, a few months. All right. Appreciate it, dude.
Hey, can you do me a favor and tell him to stop throwing me under the bus like that? I've been using that feel good speech for a while now because I've had work and everything. It don't feel so good now.
Yeah.
Talk is cheap, Roscoe.
Yeah, Roscoe, you've been talking and talking, Roscoe, man.
We're going to need to see some results about now, Roscoe, but late.
You got to get out of the loo, Roscoe. Get out of the loo, Roscoe. Brandon, you got anything else?
You going to do me like that too, man?
Yo, Roscoe, I'm just saying, man, your word, it blows away like a leaf in a tornado. Your word is about as stable as a leaf in a tornado, from what I could see, man. I'm just basing it on past experience, Roscoe, man.
I'm gonna get it together, man. I know,
Roscoe, man. I know.
You'll stop getting these cold cuts when you get it together.
Now, don't put him in a timeout, Alicia. Block him. He doesn't need to be a timeout. The only kind of timeout he needs to be is in a quiet room in a straitjacket.
He's had too much timeout with that StarCraft 2.
Right. Then put him on some downers or something like that, man. Shoot him up with some Ritalin or something like that.
Fluoride-based SSRI pills.
Some Haldol, something like that, man. Put him in a dreamlike state. A lot of hate out there. A lot of hate out there, Roscoe.
That's how they want their corners back, man. I'm telling you, Alpo, man. I couldn't go like Alpo, man. Alpo. You know, he was a tough dude, man.
Yo, man. Yo got the Alpo syndrome, man. Let his soul rest, man. Yo got the Alpo syndrome.
Man, he was a tough dude.
I hear what you're saying, King. I hear what you're saying, man. But yo, man. When the Most High calls, man, you already know what it is, man.
I see, man. They wildin', B.
That's everywhere, man. That's everywhere.
Especially down here. Hey.
Take that as a warning sign, Roscoe. Take that as a warning sign, man.
But I'm not this dude, man. He famous, man. Famous, man. I'm thinking everybody loved him, man. Welcome him home, man. With open arms, man.
That's what you think, man. But, yo, man, he was hated on the West Side. You don't really know, man. You don't really know. He was hated on the West Side, man. That side where he was on, man. He was over there on 147 in Frederick Douglass, man. Poe was from the East Side, man. Poe on the real truth, Poe should have never been over there on that side, man. He's from the East Side, man. He's from East River.
Over that way.
Yep. Killer First. Killer First, they call it. First Avenue, where they used to throw the trash cans. Oh, there's Leak right here. Hold on, man. Shalom. Peace. What's going on?
Shalom, God. Yo, check this out. Have you been watching
podcast? Nah, I haven't watched it. But my man, you got people talking about Poe all the way down in St. Louis. My man just came over here talking about Poe, man.
Huh?
My man just get now. Leak, tell him now. Listen, Roscoe. I hope you're still listening. Oh, hold on. Let me merge Roscoe in. Roscoe, you here? Roscoe, you still here?
I'm here.
My cousin right here. One hit a quarter, man. Leak, man. One of the fiercest dudes that came out of the East River Projects, man. He on the line right now. Now hold on. Let me tell you, because we're gonna dead all the rumors right now. Leak locked up and shook hands with Poe slightly before he died. Am I lying, Leak?
Yeah. Yeah, he's like, this dude, you know, Poe was a funny dude, man. So you're not lying about that at all.
Right.
He seemed like he had a real outgoing spirit about him. Oh, yeah, he's flamboyant, I tell you that. He's very flamboyant, out there in your face, like personality, you know. Good know, and I'm gonna be honest with you, man. Like our whole project right now is mourning because of what he's done for the project, man. Like, you know, some people gonna say he's a bad dude, and some people gonna love him. There's no in the middle. Either you love him or you hate him.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And most people that hate him don't even really know him. They just hate him off the movie. You understand? Off the movie that didn't tell the whole thing.
Right.
And that's why this dude, Dave Dash, was scared to come to Harlem and pulled out. Because he know he made Paul look bad. So he was scared to come to Harlem. And don't you know soon he heard Paul? Don't you know soon he heard Paul die and he was in Harlem the other day?
Yeah.
I said, this scumbag, man.
What about Flex, though? What about Flex, who leaked when Poe was going to go and check him? He wouldn't come downstairs.
He sent a lot of apology cards, too.
All right.
The Poe's scared. The Poe's left home, sorry. Just, you know, he gone down to Poe like 100 times. Flex is a bitch. Just that everybody knows this. Flex is a bitch. You know, and trust me, this is what Freeze talking about. That's zero. This is what he upset with right now. If Poe had stayed alive, which now I don't even think nobody from the streets took him, I think it was done by the police now, but they think the target shooter was an extreme shooter, like he could shoot.
Right.
So people in the project can't shoot like that.
Because they hit him five times in the chest, man.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So they say they think he's done by mistake. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, you know, Sub-Zero is saying, yo, you know what I'm saying?
Because the image, I mean, from...
Well, yo, hold on, Roscoe. You don't know what's going on, man. You're all the way in St. Louis, man. Let him rock. Let him speak, Roscoe. You got to listen, man. You're getting too many rumors.
Hold on. If you got a question, let him ask the question, though.
But look, I just wanted to say, like, because the image is, we thought, when Alpo got home, we thought everybody loved Alpo once he got home. We thought, loved them and
welcome
them
on
open arms, but
not all of New York. See, because the west side of New York, they in love with Rich Porter, the guy that Apple killed. The west side, the east side of New York, east side of Harlem. Let me get this straight. It's west side of Harlem, the east side of Harlem. West side of Harlem, they in love with Rich Porter, not Apple. The east side of Harlem was in love with Apple. You know what I'm saying? Because he's from East River Project. He's from East River Project. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So right now, the west side, they love it, the fact that he's gone. You know what I'm saying? They love the fact that he's gone. You know what I'm saying? But even back in the days when Apple and Rich was doing their thing, Apple was still more flamboyant than Rich. He was out there. You know what I'm saying? And Apple was the one that smacked the hell out of Chief Sweat, because Chief Sweat was singing to his girl in Apollo. You know what I'm saying? You know, and Richard said, yo, what you doing? You know? Apple said, this is what I'm doing. Bam! Smack Chief Sweat. You know what I'm saying? Hey, don't get it twisted. Even though Chief Sweat was a singer, he wasn't no sucker.
Yeah.
He wasn't no sucker. Because I got background check on him too. You know what I'm saying? His family, the Sweat, out there rapping project, the grand project for me, was crazy. So he wasn't no sucker, but he just Alpha was that dude that if you go there with him, you gotta really go there with him. Feel me?
Yeah.
You gotta really go there with him. You can't have stuff. You can't sugarcoat it, because he gonna bring it. You know what I'm saying? Hey, Apple not known for fighting or whatever like that, like a fist fight.
Yeah.
Like in a fist fight, many cats probably take him out. He wasn't known for that. You know what I'm saying? I mean, before prison, when he got out of prison, he got violent. and he started boxing when he was in prison.
Yeah. So that changed. But even when we came home, the guy that supposedly was talking about him, he went to these guys, yo. I mean, this was weeks before he got killed. He went to these guys and like, yo, did you have a friend on me? Damn. Dude was like, no, pull me, go. No, check this out.
Yeah.
You talking about Rand Love? That was the Apple protege, wasn't it? Cutting cats out of their clothes.
That was the Apple protege, but he got that from Rand Love. He got that from Rand Love. You know what I'm saying? And Rand Love trying to, you know. Oh, yo, and your side, you didn't know this, did you? You know, Rand Love called Freeze. He called Freeze last week.
Now, I know he called, but. What?
Well, yeah, it's pretty strong. I'm talking bad about you when I'm glamorizing you, man. I'm telling you that you was a dude I used to look up to. So how is that talking bad about you? But it was pump dollar bill don't cast old niggas right East River. They kinda envy free, they mad at free. So they go on there secretly calling these dudes the man loves and all them cats.
Wow.
Saying that Freeze was talking bad about him when he was.
Wow.
So Freeze ran up on Dollar Bill the other day with the camera. With the camera, Dollar Bill, so, you know, got out of there.
Yeah, I never heard Freeze speak ill of him, man. He always be bigging him up, man.
He never did. Anything he did it was high praise. It was high praise of Alpha and high praise of Rand Love.
Yeah, no doubt.
You know what I'm saying?
No doubt.
Straight up, you know. So that's why I asked you, did you see the stuff?
Nah.
You know what I'm saying? You gotta watch it, Joe. You gotta watch it, man, because that's what you're talking about. He came out and stepped through the whole block. You know what I'm saying? And Freeze say with his attitude he got right now, he's gonna mess around and go back to prison. He don't wanna go back to prison. But that's where they came from.
Right. Yeah, I've been seeing Freeze demeanor been like, yo, Freeze coming like, yo, man. Like, yo, he ready to sit it, man.
Yeah. And I got a point to blame myself for that too, because I've been on him. And you know what I tell you, I've been on him saying that, yo, man, stop being a sucker for money. Because I think that he reduced who he was for the project of getting these DVDs out there like he used to. You know what I'm saying? Like, when he used to interview Jim Jones and all those guys, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. How Jim Jones be talking to him. And I'm like, yo, hey, man, they don't know who you are, man. You know, only two DC, man. A legend, man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And that you would kill him. That you would really kill him. Jim Jones don't know this. The rappers don't know this. They only get rappers. They not real. You know, and now for me telling Freeze that bringing out his shoe. Demeanor, and I don't think the streets really want to see that right now. And I think I fully blame myself. I shouldn't have told him to go that route, but I couldn't take it. I stayed in the background a lot and let him make his money. But at the time when we was around a lot of rappers, you should have seen me, man. I was ready to set it off, man.
Yeah. I remember when you told me the joint. When you know, you went to Brooklyn with the whole Mano joint. Then you went to the Pink Houses when, you know, when he couldn't get nobody to go in there with him when he was interviewing Murder.
Right. Yeah. East New York. Yeah.
Yeah.
Straight like that. But I'm going to let you get back to your man. You understand? But I'm just letting you know that when you get a chance, check that podcast out. Sorry, bro.
Which one was it? It's the last one about a post traumatic syndrome.
Yeah, that one right there. All right.
Peace. Yeah. Yo, Matthew, you got anything else, King? Got anything? Matter of fact, man, before Lee call, I was about to ask you, man, do you have anything else you want to say to any brothers that might be going through the situation that you went through, man? What is your word? If you knew someone was going through this, Matthew, what would your word be for them possibly get the victory? What would your word be for them?
Get the book, Red Pill, Right Knowledge, and read it. Because it helps you out a lot. Even if they try to deny you joint custody, your Fourth Amendment, that's reserved by the Constitution, is your right to have, is a fundamental, reserves your fundamental rights. And joint custody is a fundamental right. There's a lot of cases in there that can't be overruled. But make sure you read the cases. Because some stuff can be used against you.
Come. Yo, Alicia, what are you talking about the Travis Scott tragedy? What's up with that?
Oh, he did that.
That Astroworld, man. Actually, I just did a video on it. I didn't release it, but I can go off on it. I researched a lot about Astroworld. So it's an occult satanic sacrifice that happened on Friday. And it was after the Astros lost, Astro died, then there was Astro World. Everything comes in threes, right? So get this. There was a lot of people who died, and the media only purported 8 people died, but actually hundreds of people died from the video footage and people getting trampled. And, you know, as we know, the word that I can't say was mandatory to come to the show. And it was, again, man, that's right. And, you know, and then Travis Scott,
you're getting very suspenseful.
So get this. He was wearing a shirt, Travis Scott, of like people and wearing blue. And then there was a gate, and then they were going through the gate, and they were coming out as red devils on the side of his shirt. And then when the like ambulance came, he didn't even stop the music. He kept on singing, and people screaming, "Stop the show!" It was like there's multiple accounts of people at the show. Given a testimony on Instagram, Twitter, saying that this was like it was demonic. It was like the worst thing they've ever been to. They couldn't breathe, they said. And I have some other evidence that I'll put on my channel, but like it's kind of like it's traumatic, and y'all should know not to listen to that low vibrational music. What is Travis Scott sponsored by? PlayStation, McDonald's, Nike, like, and like he stopped the concert in the past when he had his shoes taken from him. Like someone took his shoes, he stopped the whole show. People were hundreds of people dying in the show. He wouldn't stop the show this Friday. So you know he deleted his Instagram. He obviously did. He's getting sued. Him and Drake are getting sued. There's a lawsuit that's being started by Texas. what's his, let me get this lawyer, this so-called liar. Excuse me, a lawyer's name for y'all. Let's see here. So he apologized. I seen his apology. He was very insincere. Let me go off about this for real quick. Here's a couple people who died. Let me share my camera real quick here. I can do this. Give me a second here. So let me just do this. So how do I turn that on? Okay, here we go. So start camera. Just give me a second here. I'll preview some of this. So let's go with. Can I show you my? Yeah, I can show you my screen. There we go. So let's start. Start virtual camera. There we go. So here we are. So let me pull this up. So here's some of the people who died, man. Like this guy died. There's his family. This kid died. He's 14 years old. He died. Here's more people who died. Here's some footage. I'm gonna turn the audio off. This guy was there. He's giving a testimony how it was like the worst thing he's ever been to in his entire life. Here's some flowers for the people who died. Here's the police chief saying, you know, people died. Here's a video of the event. Here's the ambulance. You can see the ambulance right here. And you know, he's not stopping the music, man. Not stopping. He told everyone, put your middle finger up in the air. We're going to keep going. So here's all the people that rushed the VIP section. Here we go. Here's another body. Warning, this video contains footage that viewers might find upsetting. I flipped the video, so you're not going to get no copyright flags on this stuff. Don't worry about it. So here we go. So, I mean, the music is just demonic. I don't even want to hear it. I always mute it. It's just evil. But yeah, there's a dead guy. Keep going. Another dead guy. I mean, here's a girl screaming, stop the show. Yeah, go ahead. I couldn't hear you. What did you say? Here, this hurts to watch. It makes me sick to my stomach. Travis Scott is sick. This girl, she's saying, stop the show. Please stop the show. There's dead people everywhere. Please stop the show. This guy's saying, you got to stop the show. Stop the show. People are dying. Stop the show. Stop the show. And then the guy on the stage is like, no, get out of here. I got to film. Boot, get out of here. I don't care. I'm just going to watch the Satan show. Look at him. Look at the cameraman. He's just entranced, man. He just wants to watch. He's just like, yo, you guys, leave me alone. I want to watch this. I'm recording. So here we go. Guy, in the past, he's had people die at his shows, fall out of, like, get vertebrae broken. Doesn't care. Here's the shirt. This is what I wanted to show y'all. So let me copy this image. I'm going to open up Paint real quick here. I'm going to flip this so you guys can see this. So here we go. Here's his shirt. I got to rotate this so you guys can see this. So you guys, so here we go. Look at his shirt. Look at this. I'm going to take a blue pen. Here's people coming to the show. I'm going to do a pen. This is you coming to the show. All, you know what? I can't say that word. And then here you are leaving the show. Look at all the people passing through the gate. That's they have horns. Like, can we blow that up? Can you see this? Look at this. This is his shirt he wore when people are dying, man. He won't stop the show. Astro World. So I got.
That's what the whole cave was about. It was about the cave. It was about the Cave of Wonders in hell. When he began the show, you notice he was on top. He was as a demon with wings of fire.
Forgive me, I had the microphone muted there for a second. I have lots of more on this. Like, it's just, it gets crazier because, like, as you dig, like, I've seen videos, people, okay, here's the law. This is the lawsuit they're suing Drake, Travis Scott, Live Nation, and the venue as well. And here's this is the lawyer that's representing one of the injured people. Texas attorney Thomas J. Henry, who is representing Paredes, said there is no excuse for the events that unfolded at Energy Stadium on Friday. Now, they're trying to get a trial by a jury. This is there's Drake. Here's one of the. This is the guy that's suing Christian Paredes, 23-year-old, filed a complaint. Let's see. Is there anything else I got on this? This is the Twitter feed that was pretty crazy. Like this. So this. Okay. So there are several accounts that claim that local news at Houston is lying. There's not just eight bodies. It's close to hundreds. Astroworld just spoke to an ER nurse who was working last night. She says the news is lying. Her ER alone had 12 kids in their 20s die of cardiac arrest and numerous other calls going to the ER with the same issue. So why would 20-year-olds be having a cardiac arrest? You know exactly why people who are in their 20s would have cardiac arrest, and we can't talk about it. We're not allowed to talk about it. So, you know, it's ridiculous. Here, I'll blow this up. Check this out. So this video, look, let's pause that. Hold on. Look how creepy that is. So look, you all enter through Travis Scott's mouth. Look at that. Isn't that particularly weird? So I want to show you some more pictures of that because, hold on. I have it on. Just give me a second here. I'll pull that up. Here you go. So now you can see this. This is like a gateway. Everyone's staring into this gateway, this infinite hole that was in his mouth. Now you're in this like kind of like looks like sort of like the lake of fire is going into because there's a mountain, right? Here's his apology. I can send you a link for the apology. He's really insincere. He deleted his Instagram after he made the apology. Here's one of the girls that died. This girl died. She's 16. This guy died. Cardiac arrest. Brianna, pictured with her mother, killed at the event. Second to the left, Basil, confirmed his death on Facebook. Called it, he died of a courageous act, trying to save people. More people who died. Yeah, so this is the 16-year-old on the left, Brianna Rodriguez. Rudolph Rudy Pena, 23, he died. So, you know, as it unfolds, there's more people that are going to come forth with more people who died, man. It's just, it's all of it's really nasty. So, yeah, there's the girl. Here's the event poster. Look at this event poster, man. Like, if that isn't a cult, I don't know what is. So, man, it's just the most disturbing thing ever. Some of the artists that were playing there, Travis Scott, SZA, Chief Keef, Bad Bunny, Young Thug, Master P, 21 Savage,
wow.
Roddy Rich, Metro Boomin. Anyway, Little Baby who shot someone in Walmart. You know, this is the kind of stuff that kids listen to nowadays, right? So they're calling it the deadly concert stampede, but why would they have? Okay, they weren't stomped to death. They had heart attacks, all these people.
When did this take place?
Friday.
Wow.
So this was Friday in Houston at the NRG Concert Center.
On the Most High Shabbat. Wow.
Con. So people were going to this instead of, you know, having Shabbat. They were raging out, quote unquote. That's what Travis Scott calls it. He teaches his fans to, quote unquote, rage. He teaches them, you know, to rage. This is what happens, man. One medic's account, there was non-trained medical staff on hand responding to the matters. Why would they pose as medical staff but have no knowledge of how to respond? So this is one trained medic. Maximo 32 on Reddit says, I'm a trained medic. I was doing CPR on a girl as Drake's was coming on with Travis. Two quote-unquote medical staff came over to help. They were like a deer in headlights. They had no effing clue what they were doing. One of them straight up left. The other medic was screaming. If anyone else knew CPR, the two that came over had no ambu bag, no gloves, no AED. That's like a mini heart starter. Nothing. I had the girl's friend do mouth to mouth while the expletive medic was standing there. I'm yelling for an AED, even a damn CPR pocket mask. They eventually get a backboard and start to put her on backwards, feet on the narrow end. I call the guy an idiot and flip it over. Finally, we get her on the backboard. Cops come over and rip me off her. They pick up the backboard only to drop the girl on her face. I was so incredibly mad. I watched the girl die in front of me all because of these quote-unquote medics were so ill-prepared. I'd encourage anyone here to open a lawsuit against Cactus Jack, Astro World, BS. So sad. Wow. So it's just like – and it gets crazier. So, like, here's a video of him. So – I got to mute. The music is so demonic. I had to mute it. It makes me just look at his body. See, this guy's dead, man. Look at his dead body. And this guy is singing, man, with the auto tune going. Here's Travis Scott. You know, and then here's the body, man. Look at the body right there. That guy's limp dead, man. Cardiac arrest, heart attack. Those speakers have giant magnets in them, right? So, you know, I don't want to say, but like, man. So this kid, he's saying, I was in a concert. It was like I was in a concert in hell. That's what he's saying. I'm going to read it actually from the bottom. So I'll read you what he's saying. Felt like we were literally like in hell, bro. I felt like the concert in hell. You couldn't breathe. You couldn't see. It's just a man and all these people. They going to find the tonight that was the crowd that nobody could hear them. Just tumbling on top of them. The whole effing concert. I'm like thinking I'm probably going to be like 1,100 people dead tonight. And I was not like I was in VIP section. And it was so many bodies laid out. People was getting pulled out who was fainted. And people was trying, the medics was trying to give them CPR and was flipping them over, and they literally turning them black and blue like I never seen death in my life, bro. Just by me alone, it was probably like 10,000 people laid out dead. Just like once medics tried to responding, the next person, it was nothing they could do. Like it's effing like this, effing like that. Me up. I really just got spooked. Some demonic S word. Like it was some crazy screaming help, trying to get Travis to stop. The whole crowd was like yelling, help, help, stop. And it was scary, bro. And it was like the S word was scary, bro. It was so demonic, bro. And mind you, the music I make, I was so heavily influenced by this music, this childish music. But after tonight, like God really showed me that, you know, stay away from that S, bro. Like that. Espro sacrificed so many people, like lives tonight, for real, bro. Like so many people's lives were gone tonight because they wanted to go on to do a S word Travis show, and they influenced people to be raging and all this S word. Many people broke in and it was just chaos, bro. It was like a living hell, bro. Imagine seeing all those dead bodies. And that was just by me. So these two guys talking about their friends that died. So, and he's just mentioning that, like, were you on drugs? And they're saying, no, we didn't do any drugs. You know, this, like, yeah, man.
Wow.
It gets crazier too. Like there's videos of multiple bodies lined up leaving. This guy, he watched at home. So this Edomite, he watched at home, and he was saying that he noticed that the music was more demonic than normal. And he had watched previous Travis concerts from the Apple Live show. It was completely different from last year. I know people are saying maybe it's normal, but no, it wasn't. From listening and re-listening to it, it's not normal.
Yeah, these people look weird, man. These people you're putting on the screen, man, they look almost like animated, man. Like they look like clones. Like the people you keep putting on the screen, they look like clones, man.
So the guy that was
right here, he don't even look real, man. This dude too, he looks just off, man.
Yeah, man, they took the program, man. They're on the program.
Look at this guy's eyes, man.
Yeah, man, they're on the program. Look at their eyes, man. Yo, so this kid up here on the top, he's saying that the frequency was like they're playing some frequency that during the whole thing, even when people weren't on stage, they were playing this weird thing in the background that was like a vibration. So it was causing people to, you know, man, I want to show you this thing, but I'm kind of worried. I gotta be careful not to say anything, but like. Okay, so I want to play you something. So let me find this thing. So, yo, so magnets, so like, right, so think about this for a second, right? Like the magnets at the concert, right? So I'm not going to say what this is, but like, look at this. So like, let's say that this was like in your body, and let's say that like you're by these big magnets, these speakers, right? Look at this. Look what this fluid does, man. So you got to be careful what you put into your bodies, guys. Like, anyway, I don't want to say too much, but like you get the idea. So here's a video. This is Travis Scott from a previous concert, and he stops the music because someone takes his shoe. He stops the whole concert for his shoe. So hundreds of people dying is less important than his shoe. Anyway, so I've posted this before. Let's see here. Here's Drake and Travis inciting the crowd. Okay.
Yeah, these people, man, they under a weird vibration, man, for real. These people, man, like, wow. They're into some really weird vibrations, man, for real, for real.
So this girl is saying Astral World Festival was hell. She was talking about all the bodies. Like, she said that she, like, was rescued multiple times. People trying to pull her out of the I don't know what you would call that, mosh pit. There we go. This is the police chief saying they're going to investigate. Here's all the trash. Like, this is what the aftermath looks like. Like, it looks like it was bombed out. Like it looks like Afghanistan or something. Look at this. Like, it's just crazy. I'm trying to find this video of all the people being bought. Like, there's a video of, like, you can see, like, from the helicopters of all the ambulances. Like, it couldn't have been 8 people dead, man. It had to have been hundreds, because it's just, like, nonstop ambulances. And this one of these events happened by my house too, just recently, man. Like, I seen the ambulances go, and I heard the ambulances go all night. Like, this is common now, is that these people, they go to these events where it's mandatory to be on the program, and when you're on the program, all these heart attacks start happening. Like, it's just nuts. 20-year-olds should not be having cardiac arrest at a festival. Like, I've been to festivals, man. It's not normal. This is not normal. And it says here that one of the videos, that things that it said that it was censored, was these people are sick and worshiping the damn devil, and it's just true, man. There's more. There's just more on this. Like, it just goes on and on, man. Like, there's so much freaky stuff that went on with this. Travis saw it and smiled. There's a picture of him smiling at it. Here we go. He's smiling at the death, man. Smiles while people scream and plea for their life. They're screaming, please stop the show. So anyway, whoever in the comment asked for this, man, it was funny because I was just digging on this, and I was going to upload it, but I was like, no, some spirit came on me not to. I deleted the video I made. And so when someone asked me, I was like, okay, well, help me, help us, help me. And he's smiling, laughing, going like, what? How can you be smiling during all that? Like, you got to be really psychopathic and, like, worshiping the damn devil, man. Because if people are dying, trampling, getting trampled to death, walking over bodies, and you just get the music keep playing, like, that was a human sacrifice to Satan, and he knew it. Whoa, man. Like, just, whoa. This is the kind of stuff that's going on in the world, man. The hell mouth symbolism. So, yeah, look at, so, like, it looks like, the concert looks like this picture, man, of Hamashiach in limbo. See people entering into the mouth? It's kind of like that, man. That's what people were saying. That it was like, it was a lot like some kind of, like, satanic. Look at this. So there's, like, a funnel. People being puked out into, like, this, like, I don't even want to say, man. It just look, it's just like, look at this, man. It looks like kind of like Yidam or something, man. Like people going into the pit of hell, man, from Black Rock Mountain, man. Because that's, like, the company that, like, pushes the program, like, that's called BlackRock Investments, right? So look at this. It's a lot of symbolism with all this stuff. And it keeps going, man. Like, the true dystopia is here. Farmer, man. Like, people buy tickets. They spent money to go to this stuff, man. Oh, man, there's even more. Everyone at the Astro World News from last night had been pointing out some of Travis's symbolism recently. I looked deeper into the concert and was surprised at what I found. Right after Master P finished performing, he said, "She said, don't die tonight. I remember." Like, what? Oh, yeah. And so get this. His shirt says the possible... The concert poster shows two eyes above an entrance walkway portal with the arches. It says, open your eyes to the whole new universe and see you on the other side. This stuff is like, look at this. So there's the magnet or the speaker. And then look at all these eyes and then the hands. And this was streamed live. People watched, like, human sacrifice live and paid to do it, man. November 5th. Remember, the 5th of November. Live at the mountain. Black Rock, man. Mandatory. You got to be on the program to come to this. Got to be on the program. Part of this experiment. See you on the other side, it says. Big, big mountain. There's a speaker. See you on the other side. That's the stage, right? Big Edomite Mountain, man. Coming to Black Rock Mountain. Look at this. the infinite kind of pit of hell, the infinite tunnel, right into the, like the, it's kind of like, you know, this is like from, this is like, I don't know if the word is right, but masonry, I guess, like, you know, when they make movies, it's like the vanishing point behind the film is infinite, right? That's how they keep you hypnotized to keep watching stuff, right? So, and all these people getting crushed, and it's like people under them are dying, and they just keep their eyes on the stage, man. That's horrifying. It's like people like contributed to their deaths by stomping them out, man. It's kind of like the phoenix represents the new civilization, the, you know, old world disorder rising from the arches of destruction of the previous. All that symbolism, the circle entrance behind him and the stone shapes of the lights look exactly like the stargates in every movie TV depiction I've covered in a thread. Oh yeah. So yeah, it's like the pillars, man, from that stage. It's like the ancient Sumerian stargate, Masonic royal arches of heaven, but not the Shemayim that we're talking about on this channel. We're talking about that these, you know, this is just like, so anyway, man, you guys got to stop buying all this music, man. I want you to look in your iPods and go start deleting stuff, because I know for a fact that many of you, you want to be in the truth, but you're still under this vibration. You're still into this world, man, this worldly stuff, this oculus eye, corona symbolism. This is, so there's Travis Scott. Look at this on the speaker. There's the corona, the eye coming out the speaker. Like I told you about those magnets, man. Like, anyway, like that's not a positive vibration to be under. I want to pass the mic up in a second here because, like, geez, man. Look at all these. Yo, so get this. He's got a single called The Escape Plan. He raps about open gates. The end of the video shows a gate closing. Tons of people at the concert broke through the gates of hell to get in. Astro World cover art concert as Travis's head as a gate. That's crazy. The shirt he's wearing while performing literally shows demons walking through a dimensional gate. You cannot make this stuff up. Anyway, man, the more you look into this, it's like the Carnival of Souls. The setting of the Carnival of Souls was a deserted carnival. Astroworld is a carnival. The front of the building is the same arched keystone design as the stargates. Like Carnival of Souls. You're not really, like, if you don't really understand what you guys are listening to, like, the song that Drake is singing is mentioning a voodoo curse. A random detail I came across. Like, the amount of occult symbolism at this so-called festival, guys, like, this is not a party. Like, this is not a fun thing to be at. This is not the, like, when we have, like, the Festival of Booths and, like holy high holy days, like, this is not the same thing, guys. This is like the far opposite of the spectrum. Like this is literal human sacrifice live streamed. Like, I don't think you guys get it, man. People be heck of worldly, man. I'm gonna stop my camera. So anyway, like that's about it, man. Like I think I've said enough. There's more out there, and I can get into it, but it gets darker and creepier. And like I've seen multiple bodies, man, on stretchers. And there's that, if you watch the footage where he's the ambulance is going and the music is stopped, he gets them all to put their middle fingers up and get the music to play again, and people are screaming stop. Like that's the most horrible live performance I've ever seen in my entire existence, ever. Worse than Ozzy biting off a bat's head and Kiss biting off a bat's head, who by the way says that, like, you know, get on the program, but meanwhile he's literally eating bat heads. And that's the storyline of that whole thing, right? So it's just like, guys, you got to get better role models. Yo, Kahan, there's a lot of feedback I'm getting from you right now. Tazadaq, your microphone is all static. Unless if you're saying something right now, it just sounds like feedback. There we go. I can hear you now. For a second there. Damn. Whatever. There we go.
Yeah, he's back. It keeps blinking back. I don't know what's going on, but
You're good. You're good. You're good.
Yeah, I'm about to shut this down, man. Hopefully they don't flag because of that, you know, that content you was putting up. You just never know with these people, man.
I flipped the video and I didn't say any of the trigger words, and you know, it's just something to think about. But whatever. I hear you. Peace be with y'all. Most High willing to see y'all this weekend. Please sign up, guys.
Shalom.
Shalom. Kwame Shala. Kwame Shala.
Brenda, I'm about to shut it down, man. The mic keeps going in and out, man. So I appreciate you, man. Hopefully some brothers learn from this and everything else that was brought out here, man. All praises due to the Most High. Go ahead and, you know, subscribe to the webinar now. Pray to see you this weekend. Shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom. Shalom.